We're doing something that no one else has done before. So this is really a first foray for NASA of getting into the genetics, the genome part of science. The whole twins experience is really exciting for us overall. When the one-year mission came about and Scott Kelly was assigned, there was a recognition that, well, Scott had a twin. So why not take the opportunity to study one person in space and then one person on the ground? In our experiment, CardioOx, we're looking specifically at things that might modify or might have an effect on cardiovascular disease. So the more that we learn about cardiovascular disease risk, the more it benefits the everyday person. So the focus of our laboratory is to understand, obviously, the implications of spaceflight weightlessness on the cardiovascular system, as well as changes in the crew members' diet, their activity levels, their stress levels, their sleep patterns. These sorts of physiologic changes are ones that we would expect for people who are on for six-month transit mission to Mars. So we want to understand what are the potential health consequences, and more importantly, what are the sorts of things that we need to do to prevent them. The tough thing about doing spaceflight research is that, for example, our biological samples, in our case, the blood and urine samples from which we're deriving a lot of our science, they stay on station for a long period of time, and we have to wait for the next opportunity for them to come down. So you have these long gaps in getting actual spaceflight data, but in the meantime, you have other research studies that you're working on. So we always stay busy. We always try and keep asking new questions, things that we think will benefit both our crew members as well as the general public.
Subscribe for more space.